Hey all, today we're going to make an Arduino project resembling an old kid's toy, Simon. In Simon, you repeat a sequence of colors and sounds. Well, our spin on this will be that it's only by ear. Let's go through how you could take your Arduino from this to our project, this. So stay tuned to learn how. Let's give a quick demo of this notes project. When we turn it on, we'll see a prompt that says select game mode, and we can press 1 for practice or 2 for gameplay. If we put 1, we can basically just play a piano. Turn it up a little bit. So this can be helpful to learn the notes. And if we want to play the game, we can turn it back on and we'll play gameplay. Press number 2. It's going to play us a note and we're going to have to repeat it back. We got it right. Oh, we got it wrong. Hey guys, make sure to like and subscribe to keep this small channel growing. Thanks. So first we'll start out with the circuit diagram. To go over it really quick, in the top left you have basically your power switch and battery and LED. And then underneath that we have a DF player mini, and that's going to play our sounds and our MP3s. Underneath that is an audio module, which is just a basic op amp circuit. Then we have a custom keypad that's connected to our Arduino circuit. You can go out and buy a matrix keypad or you can use a custom one, but I'll leave that up to you. And then on the right, we have a 4x20 LCD display to show some output during the game. So first we start out with our Arduino, and then I'm adding the audio module that's pre-built. It's your op amp circuit. And then I kind of have a main board that we've set up. And on this board is the DF player mini that has your MP3s on it. And it just has a couple of buses for power and some resistors to go between the different components. So we'll start out with a battery. Let's go ahead and hook this up. So we hook up the battery. The other end of the battery will go to some buses that I have on the main board for power. The red is +9 and the black is your negative. So we're going to hook the battery up to an intermediate bus, this yellow bus, and that'll go to other end will go to a switch. And that'll just be so we could turn it on and off. So here all you have is your negative on the battery in black and your +9 on red with a switch in between. And next, we'll hook up the LED. And that's pretty simple. Basically, just connect the back of the LED to your red and black buses. Okay, let's give it a test. So far we have a battery connected to a switch and an LED. Perfect. Now, I'm also going to warn you, as this project goes, there's going to be lots more wires and it's going to look a little bit messy. So just bear in mind, this can be done a little bit prettier. So next, we're going to hook up the power source from our power bus to the Arduino. And we do that, we can hook the 9 volt directly into the VN on our Arduino and the ground to the ground on the Arduino. And the advantage of that is now we get 5 volts. So I have a blue 5 volt bus and I hook the out on the Arduino, the 5 volt out onto the blue bus. Now let's go ahead and start hooking up the DF player so this will get our audio working. So I'm going to connect the data wires. But they actually, if you look at the board, they have resistors in between. So make sure that we have, it's basically pin 2 and 3 on the DF player going to your Arduino. And we also have a tutorial on how to set up the DF player if you want to look at the link. As we go through this larger build, it's important to test as we go. So I'm going to test, and as you can see, we have the green light that shows power to the Arduino, and we also have the blue light on the DF player. So that means that the DF player is initialized and it's working properly also. Next, what we're going to do is connect the output of the DF player to the audio amplifier circuit. So this is basically the input. The output of the DF player going into the input on your op amp. And then we'll focus on powering up the op amp. So that's just your plus 9 and your ground from the power buses. And next, there'll be three wires from the potentiometer that we need to connect. And we'll just hook that up to the yellow bus that I've already got set up on our audio module. And finally, we need to connect the speaker. And so that's just two wires going to the speaker on the project box. And that pretty much completes our audio setup and our DF player. Okay, next we'll go for the LCD display. So the LCD display has four data wires on one side. So we're just going to take those. The other thing to note is now I'm going from the 5 volt source on the Arduino Mega and I'm going into a 3.3 volt LCD display. So I'm going to connect it an intermediate resistor in between each data pin. And those resistors already exist on the main board here. So I'm going to connect the four wires into the front of the resistor, and then on the out back of the resistor, we'll connect it into the Arduino. And then there's also a power, a 3.3 volt. So the 3.3 volt power, I'm going to take it directly from the Arduino 3.3 volt. On the other side of the LCD pins is pin 4 and pin 6, and those are also data wires. So we'll connect pins 4 and 6 also through resistors. So that makes a total of six data wires for the LCD panel that have to go into the intermediate resistor and into the Arduino. The first four wires go to Arduino pins 2, 3, 4, and 5. And like I said, so the RX and TX, the pins 4 and 6 off the 4x20 LCD display, will go to pins 11 and 12 on the Mega Arduino. And finally, we just hook up the keypad. So the keypad has a positive and a negative voltage. Here we're going to use the 5 volts for the keypad and the data pins for the keypad. I've used basically all the even pins on the back of the board, on the back of the Arduino. So the even pins will start at pin 42, and then I'll do 44, 46, 48, 50, 52. Those will be for the keypad data. So this is looking good. We have our LCD display working, and the keypad is also working. So that completes the build. The final thing to do is just pop this into our project box and play some games.
Let's play one more game. Oops. Still not right. Wow. Thank you.
Hey guys, make sure to like and subscribe to keep this small channel growing. Thanks.